I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
Time Sports, EVP and General Manager of our program.
Hey guys.
Was there anything about yesterday that took you off guard or surprised you at all?
You know, Connor didn't surprise me. Connor was everything that he was cracked up to be. You know, he's charismatic, he's funny, he's outrageous, he's confrontational. He showed everything that's made him a superstar. Floyd surprised me a little bit because Floyd is mellow. His last few years, he's not the biggest trash talker. He's not the trash talker that he once was. But I think in that atmosphere, the competitive juices got flowing, you know, and he felt the need to respond after seeing the way that Connor held the stage and held the crowd. The competitive came out, and the old Floyd came out a little bit as well.
It seems like it's a pro-Connor crowd again today. Mm-hmm. You know Floyd a bit. Does that sort of thing get under his skin? And how different might the atmosphere, how different would you expect the atmosphere to be on flight night?
Great question. You know, Toronto, we knew was going to be a heavily MMA crowd, a UFC crowd. It was a little surprising in Los Angeles that it was so heavily tilted toward UFC, especially since Floyd spends a fair amount of time in Los Angeles. So, you know, I wouldn't, if it was some other fighter, I'd say Mike and under his skin. Floyd revels in being the villain. He always has. So the more booze, the better. You know, what he really reacts to negatively is no reaction. So, you know, if you wanted to get under his skin, it would to be, you know, absolute dead silence when he took the stage. That would bother him. But booing, that's exactly the kind of response that he lost.
Just
wanted to
think that Mike was caught off during the
It's a little bit of the Gwang Kings. You know, this thing came together. If you look at the show and the stream, there were a little bit some technical, you know, flips. You know, Connor, you know, came out before his video. Floyd missed his cue as well. His video never played. The monitors on stage didn't work. It was a little bit of Gwang Kings. And I'm confident they'll be, you know, worked out tonight. But that was, you know, we clarified that with Connor backstage. And, you know, there were no hard feelings. I mean, he thought that it had been the case, but the whole point of this thing is to let these two guys interact with the fans and each other. And we were getting such great content, great confrontation. You know, the last thing we would want to do is fight. So I don't think you'll see that again.
Who won yesterday? If you had to pick a winner in the press conference?
You know what? I think that's this one. I think you've got to say it's a draw. You know, I'd say it was probably 6 rounds to nothing halfway through. But Floyd came on strong. He held the crowd. You know, he held his own against a really vocal Connor and a vocal crowd. So I think it's a draw. I think it'll be really interesting. You know, and we're used to talking about adjustments during fights. It'll be interesting to see how the guys adjusted and how they come out today. If there's a different approach or a different content and substance to what they're saying.
Were there any contractual provisions to ensure that neither fighter, you know, crossed a certain line or touch one another on stage?
No, you know what? At the end of this, we're relying on the professionalism of both guys. You know, there have been incidents, you know, if we go back to both guys' history. But, you know, at the end of the day, an event this big, and all the work that it takes to go into it, they both understand you're not going to mar, you know, this mega event and ruin this sort of worldwide stage with something silly like that. He's a promoter's dream. He speaks with 100% confidence and authenticity. And he's got the ability, and I think only the best WWE wrestlers even have this, the ability to say something outrageous with absolute confidence. You know, and that's something, you know, The Rock had it, you know, some of the biggest stars in WWE, but he had it. Not many people have it. Connor and Floyd both have it, you know, and whether it's they don't consider it ridiculous or outrageous, or, you know, they have become the character or caricature of themselves so much that they don't hear it anymore, whatever it is, it's completely authentic. There are a lot of a lot of people have tried to put on something similar, and it just doesn't work.
Is there an element of pro wrestling during that type of tournament?
Absolutely. You know, and you know, I haven't quite figured out who the heel is on this yet. And at certain points, they overwhelm it. But that is really what has fueled both of their rises. You don't go to, you know, from, you know, 2013 UFC debut to where Conor is on without some, you know, charismatic skills. And you're not a, you know, small, defensive-minded African-American fighter that goes, becomes a superstar without a charismatic personality. So that personality has been, you know, critical to both of their careers. I haven't seen Floyd act like that since probably the De La Hoya media tour. De La Hoya media tour was 10 or 11 cities. He browsed the live chicken with the gold medal that he started with the chicken De La Hoya. And it was some of the best stuff in recent boxing history in terms of trash talking. And, you know, and since then, he's really... You know, he's toned it down as he's got mellower, he's got kids, you know, a whole different range of factors. But you know, what we saw in Los Angeles yesterday, it's still there. You know, that the attitude, the charisma, it's still there. It may be a little bit more buried as he gets mellow, but he can still bring it out when it's necessary.
Steven, I don't know if you can answer this yet, but why Toronto? His previous press crews haven't come to Toronto. Why Toronto?
You know, our goal was really to look at major media centers, major population centers, and really combat sports, you know, capital. So, Toronto, Canada as a whole, particularly, you know, Montreal, in fact, have been really solid boxing markets. Toronto has been a massive MMA market. And so it really makes sense, you know, sort of at least from a media perspective and population and combat sports perspective. One of the, you know, stops in Canada is not the big one. So it was a goal of UFC to stop here. And when they brought it up and we evaluated, it makes sense.
If I remember correctly, there wasn't a press meeting for the pack. So why did we go back to it for this one?
You know, I think the reason why we're seeing a press tour on this pipe is because it would just be a massive missed opportunity not to. For all the stardom that Pacquiao had, he wasn't the most effervescent personality.
Right.
Like his English isn't great, he sort of played back live. It was a one-way promotion. This, you know, to not do a press
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.